Are you looking for the perfect cocktail for spring? Well, this kumquat martini will hit the spot. And I have my beautiful kumquat tree with me today that is full of fresh, beautiful, ripe kumquats. But if you cannot find them in your store, we're also making a second martini with tangerines, or cuties as I like to call them. So let's get started. If you've never tried a kumquat, I recommend trying it because they have a really unique flavor profile that is not really like anything I've ever tried before. Because they're outside, you can actually eat the whole piece of the kumquat, and it's the sweet part where the inner juices are really super tart. And I think this works really well in a martini. So what I've done is just taken 3 kumquats and I'm adding them to my cocktail shaker. And we are going to muddle these together along with some fresh mint. You can use 5 to 10 leaves of fresh mint. Okay. And don't worry if you have any seeds or anything in there, because we are going to strain this drink. Now we can add in our simple syrup, and I just made this with 1/2 cup of sugar to 1/2 cup of water, and you just cook it down until the sugar is completely dissolved, and then you let this cool fully before adding it to your drink. And I'm going to use 1 ounce of my simple syrup. And to clarify, this is a 2 ounce shot glass. The first time I made this drink, I just put like 4 ounces of tequila in it, and it was a great night, but it was a little too boozy, come to think about it. There we go. Next, I'm adding in my vodka. You can also use gin. It's just up to you and what alcohol you like better. And we're going to be adding in 2 ounces of vodka. I give a little extra shot because I spilled a little. And now I can go fill my cocktail shaker up with some ice. And now we can shake together our martini. There we go. She's ready. This is completely optional, but if you like a sweeter drink, you can always sugar rim your glasses. And I'm just taking a piece of kumquat and running it around the edges before I dip it in the sugar. Oh, and that is so pretty. I love it. So now we're just going to strain our cocktail into our martini glass. And you can have this martini just as it is, but I like to add a splash of champagne on top. Okay, and now on to our Mandarin orange martini, or you can really use any orange of choice. If you like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you could hit that like button, because it tells YouTube to send this out to more people. Thank you. And I'm just going to add in 1 peeled Mandarin orange, because you can't eat the peels. Well, I guess you could, but you don't really want to for this one. And I do recommend trying to get off as much of that white skin as possible, because it leads it to be a bit more bitter. Now I'm going to muddle this together with the juice of 1/2 of a lime. And this is a pretty big lime, I will say. Along with some fresh mint. And again, you can use around 5 to 10 leaves of fresh mint, but more the better, as I always say. And we can just muddle this together, get our arm workout in. Okay, now that this is properly muddled, we can add in our simple syrup, and we're going to add in 1 ounce of simple syrup just to give a little sweetness, along with some Grand Marnier, and you want to use 1 ounce of this as well. But if you don't have Grand Marnier, you can also use triple sec. And remember, this is a 2 ounce shot glass, so I'm only filling it up halfway to give me that 1 ounce, or else it's going to get real boozy up in here. And I'm actually going to use gin for this recipe because I want to see if I can tell which one has vodka versus gin, because I usually make my martinis with vodka. So I wanted to switch it up and do a bit more of a taste test today. And you are going to add in 2 ounces of your gin or your vodka. And now we can shake this all together, and I do need to add some ice. So I will be right back. And here I have my ice, and we can shake it all together. Okay. Now that our martini is shaken together, I'm also going to sugar rim my glass, and I'm going to use that same kumquat from before. And now it's time to pour our martini into our glass, and I do recommend straining it to get any pulp or seeds out. And I will say our Mandarin orange martini will make 2 martinis, just because there's a lot more liquid in the oranges as well as we added a few more things to it. So now it's the moment of truth, the taste test, and for me not to drop. And I have to say, I love the colors. Like, it's so spring, some yellow, some orange. Okay, I'm gonna start with my kumquat. It's so good. I love it because it's not too sweet, but adding that little bit of champagne does add a little sweetness to it, so it's perfectly balanced. Okay, now on to our orange. That is so good. I think adding the Grand Marnier to it really kicks it up a notch because this is delicious. But I love both of these cocktails. They are some of my favorite drinks to have when I'm at home. So please let me know if you try this drink and what you think in the comments down below. Also, if you'd like to see more homemade cocktail recipes, there should be a playlist right here or over here. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next week. Cheers. Well, double cheers. And don't forget to check back in next Sunday because we are making my favorite healthy brownies.